She packed my bags last night, pre-flight. 0 hour, 9 a.m. And I'm gonna be high as a kite by then.
All right, welcome back from the break. And I'm glad that you guys are back, because we're going forward. We are going forward to space with the Space Force, the Force of Space. Space goes coast to coast. Woo! I'm going to go up there and get a space gun. I'm letting y'all know right now, I am going to the Space Force. A lot of people are giving me flack about it, like Dante.
No, he's not.
Like, what are you doing, King Kimo? Why are you gonna go up there and possibly fight an alien race?
I mean, dude, there's so many other forces you could join, man. There's the, you know, there's the Power Rangers force. No,
I could be a Power Ranger. I always wanted to be the Black Ranger, despite how racist it would look. I always wanted to be the Black Ranger.
There's the Task Force, you know. There's the Tekken Force.
Oh, yeah, there's the Tekken Force. There's so many forces. But this one just catches my eyes just because it's like, it's so up there. It's so out there. I want to be out there. You know, I want to see what else is out there. And plus, I love playing this particular game called Destiny. So basically, my motivation behind it is basically, I really feel like it's going to be like this game I played, Destiny. So, you know, you're out there in space and you're shooting shit. Matter of fact, I'm gonna go ahead and play a clip of it.
Welcome to the Space Force. Here in the Space Force, we have all kind of amenities. For example, vehicles fly through endless space in a space jet that is made to fly through space. Space motorcycles. Space motorcycles are a convenient way to get around. And there's no wheels, so you don't have to worry about flats. Uniform. You basically pretty much kill monsters and take whatever clothes fall out of them in bright colorful fucking balls in the Space Force. And then they also have this bubble jacket in the Space Force. This is pretty much all I rock. I love the bubble jacket in the Space Force. Space Force bubble jacket. Space guns. The best weaponry as far as space guns. Here in space, you need a different kind of weapon. You need a different kind of weapon here in space. You can't have the regular bullets that then just fly, because gravity has a different way on things. Here you have lasers and really accurate space bullets. And the cool thing is you can carry as many as you want. You know, due to no gravity. So come to the Space Force. We'd love to have you aboard.
So yeah, basically I imagine it to be some shit like that. Awesome as fuck, right? Yeah. So that's what I think is going to be. Because guess what? Normal guns do not work in space. So you're going to have something called a space gun. And it's going to be epic. And it's going to be gear. And it's going to be loot. Because it's space.
It's like Gears of War.
Like Gears of War, exactly, bro. But yeah, basically, that's basically how I envision it as well. Gears of War, yes. Space Force, fucking Space Force. Force of space facing the force of the Space Force face. Bitches. But what were you about to say? I think you wanted to say something to the people.
I don't see why you think it's gonna be gravy like Destiny, and Trump is behind it. I don't get why you think that.
Because Trump himself looks like a Destiny character. He looks like one of those big monster things that you would shoot on one of those planets. Because he's all orange and shit. He's not a normal person's color. You would think he's of extraterrestrial form if we weren't so familiar with the form that we've seen him in for so long. He's been forced in our face, and we've now said to people, the popular opinion is he is a person at this point. If that wasn't popular opinion, I don't think people would too much question him being maybe some type of carrot hybrid.
I don't know what to think. I think there's some undercover shit going on. And he wants people to think, oh yeah, this is going to be cool. This is going to be what it is. And y'all niggas is going to be up there stranded.
First of all, what 70-year-old man just comes out and says,
exactly,
we have to have a space force. America must dominate space. We have to add this order to the next branch in military. It's been 71 years, and they haven't had any other branch. Like, they've been cool with all the branches that they have now. And now this doofus decides to stand there with his orange face, Cheeto dust dripping from his hands and tie, talking about, I demand us to get a space force. We will dominate. Now, back in the, what was it, the 60s, you had Russia. It was between us and Russia battling who was going to get to space first. Yeah. There was a whole Sputnik debacle that went down where people thought that they were sending Russian satellite spies to spy on us and whatever the case may be. And apparently, conspiracy theorists may say that Russia already went to space before we did. And John F. Kennedy was going to reveal that. And that was also one of the other reasons why, you know, he ended up the way he ended up. But if Russia already went,
he got assassinated for that?
I mean, it's a bunch of things that's tied into the Kennedy assassination. It's just so hard to pinpoint what exactly was the reason that he got taken out for, but that's on the list for that as well. He was about to say that they had already went to space before we did.
Wow.
Yeah. So from this shit happening back then to now Trump igniting or basically insinuating another space race. I don't think China has a space force. I don't know if Russia has a space force. So now we have to be the first to have a space force. What about all the other countries? They don't get to say so? Like, this is just, this is stupid. That's all I have to say about it. It's
crazy. I do admit it is stupid. It is stupid.
I mean, but not that you're going to be doing it, bro. Like, I'm going to support you 100%, man. I'm not going to be like, oh, yeah, man, have fun, stupid space station force split. No, I'm not going to talk to you like that, man. I'm going to support you, man.
I don't appreciate it.
I've been training every day. Babe, but when I send you the money back.
But you don't even know how much you want to make.
My nigga going to get paid in space rubies.
How you going to think I'm going to give you space money?
You know, space ruby. I mean, you could get a colony on Mars with that. You know, it's that's future galactic shit. Hold on, we have a woman on Earth that has three titties. You gotta, well, gotta play the clip of her.
Getting all that, whatever the fuck is out there. I don't want that.
We gonna play.
I don't want it at all. Like, I'm keeping it 100. And you didn't talk to me about this before. Chose to do it. I don't know why.
Dude, she doesn't want to grow three tits like the one lady.
I don't.
That got those surgically
that
attached.
That would be him enjoying.
So nobody space. Would holler at
him. He would never want to come home having a bitch with three titties. Like, come on.
That's
like, no.
That's a lot of milk.
Slapping him like bongos.
There you go. And then all the space ass that's probably out there. I'm good. I think we might have to get it.
But space, you don't want to get a space ass disease.
Yeah, what's that like? Oh no. Oh, God, no. It's got a horrible image.
But what if a space disease is actually something that would make you, like, superhuman, though?
That's a freaky thought to have.
I'm just keeping it 100. Because the diseases that we got here kill you. So I would think that if they're advanced, like, people think that they are out there, then I'm sure that they already have cures for everything that we already had or have. You know what I'm saying? So right. Whatever you get up there has to do something to change your shit, and not for the bad, I would think for the good.
That's considering that they want to do you well for whatever reason. Mm. You know, you got to think about it like this. We kind of stump on ants. What if we are this universe's ants to other people, and Now we have to make a small defense against what's the simulation of a gigantic boot to our anthill. You know, it could be a situation like that to where we're that.
We're ants. How are we going to defend ourselves from a gigantic boot?
Well, I guess the first step would be getting a space force. Join the space force, everybody.
All right. That's the campaign right there.
That'll be the first. You don't want to be an ant in your anthill. You want to be an armadillo in your ball form. Join the Space Force.
And burrow that shit out.
Our logo is literally going to be an armadillo.
I'm
going to have a word with them because I think they're strong animals. They have dragon spirit.
Plus, if you pick them up, they got a lot of bacteria and stuff, too.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, for real?
Yeah, and you don't want to go around touching armadillos.
You don't want to play with the armadillo.
I would never. They don't look like they play for animals anyway.
That's how America is. We're not playful animals.
This is America. Don't get your slipping, no.
We're armadillos.
Yeah.
Anyway, guys, join the Space Force. That's what Trump's talking about. I'm going to play the clip. Here we go.
So he's directing the Department of Defense.
America, it is not enough to merely have an American presence in space. We must have American dominance in space.
For the first time in 71 years, the American Armed Services will gain, which is the responsibility for providing space safety data and services. Trump's space plans,
blah, 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 blah,
is not only a matter of national identity, but a matter of national security. So important for our military.
So important.
The fuck?
Hey.
I totally agree with you there. It's so important for us to get some motherfuckers out there in space to be guarding our shit from a spatial form.
Whose ass are we going out there to kick?
Exactly. Like, who's out there? Who's out there? And how do you know that they're out there? So now what you're doing is now you're igniting the whole Roswell shit. You're igniting the whole Area 51. I mean, what are you really saying by saying we need a dominance in space? Why do we need a dominance? Why?
Somebody's got to admit that there's aliens, damn it.
Yeah, just say that.
Kennedy didn't get a chance to admit. We know Reagan wasn't going to admit. We know Bush wasn't going to admit. Or young, dumb Bush wasn't going to admit. Obama almost admit that there was aliens, but then he was like, nah, I'm black. I can't be telling y'all this shit. And then Trump comes out with this. So
Trump is admitting it.
Somebody's got to admit. This idiot. Shit. Yeah.
This idiot. Like, he's an idiot. Like, he's actually admitting that this shit is for real, and this is the reason why we need it.
Doofus.
Because it's like, why do we need the wall?
A wall is pointless if we about to go fight off aliens.
Exactly.
We crossing a bigger problem. Exactly. We're just going to dismiss illegal aliens and go after the actual aliens in space. Like, let's just drop this border shit. That's why this nigga signed an executive order today. It's like, all right, fuck it. Aliens, illegal immigrants here. All right, cool, whatever. Let's go after the real aliens. That's what we're going to fight right now.
We're setting up borders in space. It's not just about the wall. God. I'm building a wall high as space. That's what Trump's about to do. He's about to build a wall as high as space.
This nigga is, I don't know whether to believe that he's actually crazy or actually very sane. And we're the crazy ones. I think that that's what the issue is. Like, is this nigga so crazy that he's actually, like, sane? Like, you know what I mean?
He can't even read.
It just doesn't make sense. It doesn't. Like, I don't understand why he's still in office. Why? What are we benefiting from him being in office right now? How are we progressing in any way?
This fool can't even raise money to build a border wall. How the hell he gonna build a space wall?
That's why we're getting a space force.
See, there you go. No. and don't even know what y'all are in for, really. Because if it's really popping like that out there, do you really think you want to survive?
Independence Day.
I've seen enough of Starship Troopers.
Is Will Smith going to be part of the Space Force? Because
exactly.
He seems to be in every intergalactic movie that comes to do with doing battle and shit.
He better be.
So is he going to be like the top general, that nigga?
I feel a hell of a lot better about being on the Space Force if he was there.
Okay.
Will Smith joined the Space Force.
We'll recruit him, man. All right. You got to bring Jaden Smith too, man. Because, you know, After Earth, man. You know.
Oh, yeah. Jaden.
Exactly. Got to bring him too, man. Yeah.
That was a good movie.
He's gonna confuse them aliens. So Jada Smith's going to do. He's going to confuse the fuck out them aliens. But what is going on with this kid? Is he one of us?
After Earth was a good movie, though.
Yeah. I got to go see it.
Space Force.
But anyway, guys, closing segment. This segment right here, we're going to definitely say, hey, join the fucking Space Force. Support your country in the space. Against space.
I've been working this grave shift, and I ain't paid shit. I wish I could buy me a spaceship and fly.
I swear I do.
Past the sky.
GLC.